Took a big hit from Cal Clutterbuck, and he is down. I don't believe there's a penalty as Brady Tkachuk comes over to talk to Clutterbuck. I believe the whistle is for the concern for Brannstrom.
Yeah, he's definitely there. They want the trainer out there.
Is in a lot of pain.
Yeah, David, they're calling for the, it's, I don't think it's good, guys. They're calling for more than just the trainers right now.
Yep, they're calling for the doctors and the medical staff.
Yeah.
The EMS will come out onto the ice, and all the doctors
so wherever
making
they
their
are.
Way to the ice right now. Coming down right through the Islander bench area as the concern is for Brannstrom. And I think the problem was, and you can see Damian Hess, the Islanders athletic trainer, right there as well.
They're bringing out a stretcher right away, too.
It was the way Brannstrom, I think, his head hit the ice, and that's the concern. So they tend to Erik Brannstrom after the big hit from Cal Clutterbuck.
From a player's perspective, guys, I'll tell you, it doesn't matter what color jersey you're wearing. Cal Clutterbuck's the one that made the hit. I know that he's feeling the exact same way. It doesn't matter what team anyone's on. This is not a good sight for anyone.
Yeah, I'm not seeing any blood. Thomas, are you seeing where he's bleeding at all from your perspective?
No, I was completely blocked out.
It's the impact of Brannstrom, not on the hit, but on the landing on the ice. Because his legs went straight up, and there was no way to protect himself. And you can see he's out on contact. So
yeah, there's probably a possible concussion there as he lands right on his head, totally off balance, no way to protect himself.
And so the Islanders medical staff comes out immediately to tend to Brannstrom. It is a sight you never want to see. As he has been completely immobilized, no doubt on his way to a local hospital. But a tip of the cap to the medical staff from both teams. Getting there within seconds, the officials as well for making sure that was possible. And now comes a difficult challenge of turning the engines back on and playing hockey once again.